Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And it's nippy out today. We've had some snow. Yesterday was really, really windy, and now it's in the 30s.
Oh, it was 23 yesterday.
Yes, it was. But now is the perfect time to harvest kale, because kale gets better as it gets colder out. And until there's a really hard frost, it'll just keep on going. So today I'm kind of cutting them down as far as I can go without actually chopping them out. But you can see that little leaf there is still going strong.
Now, and would you cut all these old leaves off these, then?
Well, no, because I think it might need some of them just for making food for itself.
Okay.
I might take some of the bigger ones off just so it doesn't look goofy.
Yeah.
But you'll notice that some of these have been touched by the frost, but they've also been chewed on a little bit. And some of them seem to have some mildew on, so I'm not going to be using those. But if you look down inside, you see these nice,
tender leaves.
Tender new leaves that are perfect either for eating raw, because now they're sweet, or let me just take one like that. Just check for insects. I don't want to eat protein. And instead of having that harsh kale taste to it, it's just tender and sweet. So I am giving some of these to our son and his wife, especially these tender ones. And some of these other ones that look good. And I wouldn't pick that one because that one's got a little mildew on it. So I don't like that one. But I'll go over to this one and look for these brighter green ones. Perfect. Succulent. Now what I'm going to do, once I get their bag filled, I'll go through and I'll take some of the...
I can even smell it from here.
I know. Smells good, doesn't it?
Yes.
And I'm going to be drying it. Now I've already done a bunch. I've dried a bunch in our food dehydrator, and I've been using it in our chili and in casseroles and stir fries. It's wonderful. Now here's a leaf that doesn't have any mildew on it. And it's probably, you know, would be good to use, but it's just so old and leathery, I don't know. What do you think? Maybe I'll take one that's a little younger.
That's a good one.
Mm-hmm. And these would be nice.
Yep. That sun feels nice.
Yes, it does.
The wind died down.
Oh, greatly.
We're having, 25 foot?
Oh, yes, waves.
Waves that were splashing over the breakwater, and
yes.
It was quite a sight to see.
Oh, there was winds of 35 to 40 miles an hour.
Well, that's mild, though.
When you're standing there and it's coming off the lake spraying you.
A lot of people
dramatic.
Got a free car wash yesterday, I'll say that. Now, what are some of the things that you can do with kale? Obviously, you can have it in a salad, and you know, you can dry it and put it in soups and so forth.
Stir fry. You can use it in a stir fry.
Now, we had talked about smoothies this morning.
Or juicing. Right.
And there's a problem with kale and juicing.
Yes, well, there's not much juice in it. So when you juice it, you barely get anything out of it because there's no juice.
Yeah, but what fiber?
The fiber. Now, if you put it in a smoothie and you're going to get all the fiber, that would be a good thing to do with it. People just like it in salads, too. It's just, especially at this stage, because it's so tender and sweet.
It's terrific.
It's totally different than if you eat it in the summertime when it's very pungent and
bitter.
And sort of bitter, yep. It has its own thing to it. It sometimes makes my throat feel raw when I eat it in the summer, but not now. Not at all.
No, it's
totally
super,
changed.
Super sweet.
Yep. And it is a cool crop. It's a crop that likes to grow in cool weather. We planted this probably in June, which was, you know,
way
the
late.
End of the season for planting it. But it grew throughout the winter or the summer because it was shaded partially by our lovely maple tree here. And now it's just perfect.
I mean, your plants are about 2 foot tall.
They are healthy plants.
Now, the kale that we really like, though, is dinosaur kale.
Yes, and we have a little bit of that over there. And I'll have to go around in order to get in there. This is the dinosaur kale. Guessing it's called that because it looks like you would expect dinosaur skin to look. And that is lovely. That one I'm going to keep for myself. Sorry, Keith.
Oh, sure. Keep the good stuff.
Lovely.
Those are...
Yeah.
I remember the first time we had it at the farmer's market that time.
Yes.
I think it was Jenner Farms that was producing it and selling it during the winter time.
Don't get confused with spinach now.
No,
spinach that they had also.
Oh, that's true.
Yes.
But their kale was delicious as well.
Yes. This is another kind. I'm not quite sure what kind it is. I probably wouldn't use that leaf, but these would be good. There was a kind that I believe is this one over here that was the scarlet. Now, when I asked the woman, I got that at the farmer's market. She said that was the sweetest. That was her favorite of all, which is the scarlet. It's more of a crinkly. And look at this. It's really crinkly when it's little. Yeah. Want a taste of this?
Yes, I do.
Let me get rid of these because I don't really want those. And I'll be cleaning that all up just so you don't think I'm just throwing it on the ground and mixing it in. Okay, here we go. How does that taste? It just feels so healthy.
It does. I don't know how to describe it. It has a bite to it.
A little bit. But not bad.
Mm-mm.
Not that any of it's bad.
I need a piece of dinosaur kale.
Okay.
To wash this down with.
All right, here. She made a sandwich. That's another thing. You could put this in a sandwich instead of a piece of lettuce or a piece of cheese.
Like a lettuce wrap.
You could put it, sure. That'd be another way to use it. Another thing that I'm harvesting right now is the beets. We planted these as a second crop. So this was later, probably in late July, maybe early August. And I had some seeds left and I had a space, so I popped them in. And now they're perfect size for eating, for juicing. And these leaves are extremely high, I believe, in iron. They're very good for you, kind of like a spinach. Again, you can use them in a salad, you can use them in a sandwich, you could add them to your soups. It'll have the flavor of beets, but it won't have the redness of the beet.
Well, I got to tell you, if I had a salad, I would want a kale salad.
Dinosaur kale salad?
No, any of them. And throw on some beets with that, and wow.
Yep. Very healthy.
I'm still salivating and chewing and, you know, it's all the little granules are still in my mouth.
Is that a good thing?
It's delicious. I could snack on this for hours. I will say this, though, it does get in your teeth. Between your cheek and gum.
In a good way.
Well, you think they'll have enough salad for tonight?
Yeah, that'll be good for them.
Okay, so now can we harvest ours?
Yes.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to eat it all?
Nope.
Okay.
That's good. Well, hopefully you have something left in your garden.
Oh, before we go, I want you to look at this.
Oh. I know we showed this in an earlier video, but this is called broccoli cabbage. It was in the Chinese section of the Chinese broccoli, it's called. This was how they had it advertised. It doesn't kind of look like that to me, but this is how it turned out. And you said it tasted like lettuce?
Well, I took one of these light little leaves.
Okay, well, let me try one. Okay, it's very pretty.
Yes. See, that's why I'm saying I'd like to have that in a salad.
It tastes like cabbage to me.
Well, it's supposed to be. I think we should harvest this little one for now.
This one?
Yeah. So they come in little clusters.
I don't know. I guess so.
Wouldn't that be pretty in a floating in a soup?
Mm-hmm. Mm. Plus it'd add a crunch.
Very tasty.
Yes, it is. Very tasty. It sort of has a cauliflower broccoli kind of taste to it. And then the other thing, the one other thing that we still have is some Swiss chard. We had the yellow stemmed and the red stemmed from our friend Ranjit, who brought us the buckets, and I never even got to plant them in a bucket. They just are still in the little pot he gave them to me. And
you want to cut a little piece off of there? I want to try some of that too.
All right, let me give you a...
How about that little one there? Yep.
So pretty.
Mm.
You like that?
It's amazing the difference in flavors.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, just that subtle difference, and I can't even say it's a subtle difference. It's a distinct difference.
Oh, yes. Yes. Well, that's why it's good for diversity in your garden, because you never know during a year what is going to actually do well and what might not do well, and it might be the same garden, you planted at the same time, but because of weather conditions or insects or whatever, something will thrive and something won't. And if you've just planted one kind of thing, like when they used to plant only elm trees, and then the Dutch elm disease came and they wiped out all the elm trees. Plant a diversity of things in your garden and you'll always have something that's doing well.
Even if you have a little patio, have little pots with different things in it, you'll be delighted.
Oh, it's fun. If you enjoyed this video and you learned something, please give us a thumbs up. And thank you so much for watching and commenting and letting us know what's going on in your garden. If you'd like to join our family, please subscribe. We'd love to have you.
Mm. So where is this going?
This is going in the house temporarily, and then it's going to go in my stomach.
Do I get one too then?
Sure, I'll pick some for you.
Okay.